In this video, I will show you how to install visual mods to Kerbal Space Program version 1.3.1 to add clouds, city lights, windows reflections, better terrain and part textures and much more. So on my channel you can already find one extremely popular tutorial, which I made a few months ago. But that one was for modpack called Andromeda Visuals Daydream, which was nice and easy to install, but currently it has some problems with license on KSP forum and the latest version is buggy. I used that modpack on my video from one huge mission where I visited all KSP Easter eggs and it looked awesome. But what I prepared for today should be even better. Firstly, scroll down to the video description of this video, where you will find all links which you will need during the installation. Also make sure you have something which can work with archives, for example WinRAR. And let's start by opening SVE or stock visual enhancements and download mod along with textures. You can choose from three options, high, medium or low resolution. And to install it, open up Steam, right click to Kerbal Space Program, Properties, Local Files and browse local files. This will open up Kerbal Space Program installation folder, and if you can, I highly recommend you to make clean KSP installation just for this purpose. And all downloaded mods you will be putting into game data folder. And once you will be done with that, download EVE or environmental visual enhancements, but download and install just base mod, not configs, because SVE already has configs, and if you install both, you will end up with overlay cities light or cloud layers. Now it's time to install Skater for better looking atmosphere and water reflection with waves. Again, download it and copy Skater to game data folder. You will also need module manager, but it is included with almost every single mod, so it is useless to download it separately, but if you want to, you can. Another thing which you should have is stock visual terrain or SVT for much better looking textures of celestial bodies. So download it, but don't forget to install also mod Copernicus by dragging all files into game data folder. And at this page you can see the difference between stock textures and these new. And if you want to take it to another level, I will show you other interesting things. For example, this raster probe monitor, which will add you real and functional displays to cockpit on which you can monitor telemetry, cameras for landing, and you can combine this mod with docking port alignment for docking from cockpit, scan set or vessel view, which is very cool mod too. Real plume will add realistic engine exhaust plume. And to install it, you will need Real Plume, Smoke Screen Mod and Module Manager. All download links are on KSP mod post. And now it's time to install Reflection for windows, solar panels and everything glossy with mod Window Shine. But first of all, install Texture Replacer from mod forum and then Window Shine to game data folder. And last but not least are parts textures, called Vanstock Revamp. And after you install this last one, make sure that your game data folder looks exactly as mine. There are other mods, for example Distant Object or Planet Shine, which could make slight difference, but Planet Shine is for version 1.2 and I'm not sure that is working exactly as should. But you can install these two mods, but it is optional. Now launch your game and make sure that everything is working as should and you don't have any articles, extremely poor performance, glitches or things like that. Okay guys, that's it for today. If you have any suggestions or you will need help with something, I will try to help you in the comment section as in previous video, where I replied to every comment. Like, dislike, share and I will see you in the next video. Bye!